Another day, another story. The switch to the Gregorian calendar was a significant event in history that aimed to reform the Julian calendar, which had been in use for centuries. The transition from the Julian to the Gregorian calendar took place in October 1582, and as a result, 10 days were skipped to bring the calendar back in line with the solar year. Here are the key points regarding the switch to the Gregorian calendar and the 10 days that vanished. Welcome to Tarbo Eminent Channel. Background. 1. The Julian calendar, introduced by Julius Caesar in 46 BCE, had a small error in its calculation of leap years, causing it to drift out of sync with the solar year over time. 2. By the 16th century, the Julian calendar was about 10 days behind the solar year. Gregorian calendar reform. 1. Pope Gregory XIII introduced the Gregorian calendar in October 1582 as a reform of the Julian calendar. 2. The reform aimed to bring the date of the spring equinox closer to March 21, the date it was in the Council of Nicaea in AD 325. 10 days skipped. 1. To align the calendar with the astronomical year, 10 days were skipped. 2. In most Catholic countries, Thursday, October 4, 1582, was followed by Friday, October 15, 1582. 3. The days between October 5 and October 14 were simply omitted. Protestant adoption. 1. Protestant countries were initially resistant to adopting the Gregorian calendar, viewing it as a Catholic innovation. 2. Over time, however, they gradually accepted the calendar reform. Global adoption. 1. The adoption of the Gregorian calendar was not simultaneous worldwide. 2. Catholic countries were the first to make the switch, and others followed at different times. 3. Great Britain and its colonies, for example, did not adopt the Gregorian calendar until 1752. Impact on birthdays and anniversaries. 1. People who were alive during the calendar switch experienced a sudden adjustment of their recorded birth dates. 2. The missing days led to confusion, and some people resisted the change. Easter calculation. 1. The reform also included changes to the calculation of the date of Easter to bring it in line with the original practices of the early Christian Church. Papal bull. 1. The reform was implemented through a papal bull titled Inter Gravissimas, issued by Pope Gregory XIII. The Gregorian calendar is the calendar system most widely used today, but it took time for its adoption worldwide. The adjustment of the calendar was a significant step in improving the accuracy of timekeeping and aligning the calendar with astronomical events. Pope Gregory XIII's motivation. 1. Pope Gregory XIII's decision to reform the calendar was influenced by the fact that the spring equinox was slowly drifting away from March 21, the date set by the First Council of Nicaea in AD 325. 2. The Pope sought the advice of astronomers, including Christopher Clavius, to develop a more accurate calendar. Clavius and the new calendar. 1. Christopher Clavius, a Jesuit mathematician and astronomer, played a crucial role in the design of the Gregorian calendar. 2. Clavius was tasked with creating a system that corrected the errors in the Julian calendar and accurately reflected the solar year. Adjustment of leap years. 1. One of the key modifications in the Gregorian calendar was the adjustment of leap years. 1. In the Julian calendar, a leap year occurred every 4 years without exception. 2. The Gregorian calendar retained the leap year every 4 years but introduced a rule to skip leap years in century years unless divisible by 400. 2. This modification corrected the overestimation of the solar year in the Julian calendar. International adoption. 1. The adoption of the Gregorian calendar varied across countries and regions. 1. Catholic countries in Europe, including Italy, Spain, and Portugal, were among the first to implement the reform. 2. Protestant countries, however, were initially hesitant due to the association of the reform with the Catholic Church. Calendar in the New World. 1. the transition to the Gregorian calendar had interesting implications in the New World. 1. When the British colonies in North America finally adopted the Gregorian calendar in 1752, it resulted in the Gregorian calendar riot in some places. 2. People protested the loss of days, and there were reports of confusion over the adjustment. Cultural and literary impact. 1. The calendar switch left its mark on literature and culture. 1. William Shakespeare, for example, was born and died under the Julian calendar, but his plays are often dated using the Gregorian calendar. 2. Some works of literature and historical documents include both Julian and Gregorian dates to account for the transition. Dual dating. 1. To mitigate confusion during the transition, a practice known as dual dating was employed. 1. This involved using both Julian and Gregorian dates in documents. 2. Dual dating was especially common in the period around the calendar switch, creating a unique historical record. Scientific implications. 1. The calendar reform had implications beyond religious and cultural considerations. 1. The alignment of the calendar with astronomical events facilitated more accurate scientific observations and predictions. 2. It also paved the way for a more systematic approach to timekeeping, a crucial aspect of scientific inquiry. Global standardization. 1. Over time, the Gregorian calendar became the global standard for civil use. 1. International events, commerce, and communication began to rely on a standardized calendar, contributing to the globalization of timekeeping. The transition from the Julian to the Gregorian calendar was a multifaceted process with scientific, cultural, and historical implications. Its impact resonates through the centuries, influencing how we measure and record time in the modern world. The transition from the Julian to the Gregorian calendar was not without its challenges and controversies. Here are some additional aspects of the story. Resistance and skepticism. 1. The calendar reform faced resistance from various quarters. 1. Some people were skeptical about the need for the change, while others saw it as an infringement on tradition. 2. In some regions, there were fears that the skip days meant that individuals would be cheated out of a portion of their lives. Cultural and religious significance. 1. The calendar switch had cultural and religious implications. 1. Many festivals and religious observances were tied to specific dates, and altering the calendar affected the timing of these events. 2. Some festivals had to be recalculated, and adjustments were made to accommodate the change. Gradual adoption. 1. The adoption of the Gregorian calendar was a gradual process. 1. While Catholic countries in Europe quickly embraced the reform, other regions took longer to make the switch. 2. Eastern European countries, for example, adopted the Gregorian calendar much later, with Greece being one of the last to do so in the 20th century. Adoption in British territories. 1. In British territories, including the American colonies, the adoption of the Gregorian calendar was delayed until 1752. 1. In that year, the calendar adjustment involved skipping 11 days to bring the British calendar in line with the rest of Europe. 2. This adjustment led to protests, with people demanding that they be compensated for the lost days. Sweden's unique approach. 1. Sweden, in an attempt to avoid the loss of days, decided to gradually phase in the Gregorian calendar by omitting leap days for several decades. 1. This approach allowed them to align their calendar without skipping days. Calendar confusion. 1. The period during and after the calendar switch was marked by confusion. 1. Documents and records from that time often included both Julian and Gregorian dates to avoid ambiguity. 2. Historians and genealogists today sometimes face challenges in interpreting historical records from this period. Scientific basis. 1. The Gregorian calendar was introduced with the help of astronomers and mathematicians who provided the necessary calculations to correct the inaccuracies of the Julian calendar. 2. The reform reflected a growing reliance on scientific methods in various aspects of society. Legacy. 1. The Gregorian calendar eventually became the de facto standard worldwide, used for civil purposes, international communication, and everyday life. 2. The calendar switch is a fascinating chapter in the history of timekeeping, illustrating the intersection of religious, cultural, and scientific influences. The transition to the Gregorian calendar was a complex and multifaceted process, and its effects were felt not only in the realm of astronomy and mathematics but also in the daily lives and cultural practices of people around the world. When it comes to calendars, small errors can add up over time. The Julian calendar, the prevalent calendar in the Christian world for the first millennium CE and part of the second millennium, was an improvement over the Roman Republican calendar that it replaced, but it was 11 minutes and 14 seconds longer than the tropical year, the time it takes the sun to return to the same position, as seen from Earth. The result was that the calendar drifted about one day for every 314 years. One of the most pressing problems caused by the error was the increasing difficulty of calculating the date of Easter, which the Council of Nicaea in 325 had decreed should fall on the first Sunday following the first full moon after the vernal equinox, which at the time fell on March 21st. The growing discrepancy between the date set by the council and the actual vernal equinox was noted in the 8th century CE, if not earlier, and a number of proposals for reform were brought before popes in the Middle Ages. But no action was taken, and the Julian calendar, flawed as it was, remained the official calendar of the Christian Church. In its session of 1562-63, the Council of Trent passed a decree calling for the Pope to fix the problem by implementing a reformed calendar. But it took another two decades to find a suitable fix and put it into place. After years of consultation and research, Pope Gregory XIII signed a papal bull in February 1582 promulgating the reformed calendar that came to be known as the Gregorian calendar. The reforms were based on the suggestions of the Italian scientist Luigi Lilio, with some modifications by the Jesuit mathematician and astronomer Christopher Clavius. The most surreal part of implementing the new calendar came in October 1582, when 10 days were dropped from the calendar to bring the vernal equinox from March 11th back to March 21st. The Church had chosen October to avoid skipping any major Christian festivals. So, in countries that adopted the new calendar, the feast of St. Francis of Assisi on October 4, 1582, was directly followed by October 15. France made the transition separately in December. Something as complex as implementing a new calendar couldn't go off without some complications, though. The Protestant and Orthodox countries didn't want to take direction from the Pope, so they refused to adopt the new calendar. The result was that Catholic Europe, Austria, Spain, Portugal, Italy, Poland, and the Catholic states of Germany suddenly jumped ahead of the rest of the continent by 10 days, and traveling across a border often meant traveling forward or backward on the calendar. Eventually, non-Catholic countries did begin to adopt the Gregorian calendar. The Protestant regions of Germany and the Netherlands switched in the 17th century. Great Britain and the territories of the British Empire followed suit in 1752, spreading the Gregorian calendar around the globe. Thanks for watching. Request you to subscribe the channel.